Now here we are having some different examples than the previous video lecture, and we have to follow the same procedure as we are following from the previous lectures, fine. So here these are the examples for the Master's theorem, fine. I already explained how to identify whether you have to solve the given equation using the Master's theorem or using the logarithmic recurrence relation method. Fine. So here we have to solve this numerical using the Master's theorem. Fine. So here, what is the value of a? A it is 6. What is the value of b? B it is. You have to divide to calculate the value of b. You have to divide the numerator and denominator by 9. Fine. That means 9n divided by 9 upon 6 divided by 9. Fine. So it is b is equals to n divided by 6 divided by 9. That means what is the value of b? B is 6 divided by 9. Fine. And what is the value of f of n? F of n it is log n. F of n it is log n. Fine. So you have to first calculate n to the power log of a to the base b, and you have to compare it with the f of n value. Fine. So I will calculate n to the power log of a to the base b. That is n to the power log of a. What is the value of a? A it is 6, and the value of b? B it is 6 by 9. By value of b it is 6 by 9. That is equals to 2 by 3. Fine. So I will calculate log of 6. N to the power log of 6 divided by 2 by 3. Fine. So I will use Kelsey there. So what is the value of n to the log of 2 by 3, base 2 by 3, and it is 6. So it is n to the power log of, what is the value of 2 by 3? 2 by 3 it is 1.6, and it is 6. 1.6 and it is 6. Fine. So n to the power log of 1.6 and log of 6. And base is 1.6. What is the value? So I will use the calculator for this. So I will use here. Here it is on. And then we have to calculate the value. Fine. So we have to take the log. Log it is different base. Fine. We have to change the base. That's why I am using this log. Fine. And it is 1.6. Base is 1.6. And what is the value? Log of 6. Fine. So it is 3.81. So n to the power 3.81. It is n to the power log of a to the base b value. Fine. And what is the value of f of n? F of n it is log n. Fine. So directly we can't calculate both of this value and compare both of this value. Fine. So we have to use some of the n values to calculate, to compare whether f of n is greater than this n to the power log of a to the base b, or whether n to the power log of a to the base b is greater than f of n. Fine. So I am dividing this into the three part. Fine. So see here carefully, note it down. So first value is n to the power 3.81, and here f of n value is log n. Fine. So how many values I will use for the n? I can put here n number of the values, but the iterations we can time maximum to the 5. Fine. So I am using n is equals to 1 here. So 1 to the power 3.81, and then 1 to the power 3.81, and then log of 1. Fine. So 1 to the power 3.81 I am getting 1, and log of 1 it is 0. Fine. You can put this value into the calculator and you can find it, find out the values. Fine. So what is the next consequent value? N is equals to 2. If I am using n is equals to 2, then 2 to the power 3.81 is equals to, I will get sum of the values and log of 2. Fine. So 2 to the power 3.81 I can use here Kelsey. So 2 to the power, what is the value? 3.81. Fine. So I am getting 14.025. That is 14.02. And what is the value of log 2? I am using here log. as here no change of the base, that's why I am using the normal log. Log of value it is 2, fine. So log of 2, I am getting here 0.301. So in the first iteration, which value is greater? n to the power 3.81 is greater as compared to log n. And on the second iteration also, this value is greater as compared to the f of n or the log n value, fine. So I am again checking for the third iteration, n is equals to 3. If I am using n is equals to 3, so what is the value here? 3 to the power 3.81 is equals to sum of value I will get, and log of 3 is equals to, fine. Again I am using the calculator for here. So 3 to the power, which value it is? 3.81. So here I am getting 65.74, and here log of 3 value, I want log of 3, fine. So I am getting 0.477, fine. So consequently you can observe here this value is greater than f of n value, fine. So I came into conclusion that n to the power log of a to the base b is greater than f of n. So which case it is? It is case 1. So in the case 1, you have to follow the generalized equation or the equation for this format, that is t of n is equals to, which value is greater? That's why I am putting this value into the bracket, n to the power log of a to the base b, fine. So t of n is equals to theta of n to the power 3.81, fine. So this is my numeric, this is my solution for my first numerical. So if you are unable to compare directly n to the power log of a to the base b and f of n values, you have to use some of the n values, and we have to put here next consequent number of n, and after getting the appropriate solution for it, whether it is the f of n value is greater or f of n value is less, you can stop the iteration and you can find out the answer here, fine. So here we can again going to the next numerical. So my next numerical is t of n is equals to 4t 3n by 6 plus root n, fine. So again here a is 4, b is here. Again I have to divide the numerator and denominator by 3. So 3n divided by 3 and 6 divided by 3. So 6 divided by 3 it is 2, fine. So b is equals to here I am getting 2, fine. And f of n is equals to here root n, that is n to the power 1 by 2 here, fine. So I will again find out the value, which value? N to the power log of a to the base b, fine. So n to the power log a, it is 4, to the base b it is 2, fine. So I am getting n square here. So you can use calculator here and find out the log of 4 to the base 2, fine. So you will get n square here, fine. So can you calculate, can you compare directly the f of n value and n to the power log of a to the base b? Yes, you can, but if I want more appropriate answer, then I am using again the next consequent value of n. I will put here and will directly compare it by putting the values, fine. So n to the power log of, that is n square, and f of n value is root n, fine. If n is equals to 1, so n square value I will get 1, fine. And root n value again get, I am getting 1, fine. So for the first iteration, these are the equal values. For the second, n is equals to 2, I will get 2 square, that is 4, and root of 2, fine. So I will use here root of 2, fine. So I will use here the calculator. So what I will get? I want 2 under root, fine. So 2 to the power again 1 by 2, that is 0.5 it is. So I am getting 1.414. 414. Fine. So which value is greater again? N square is greater. For the second again, for the last iteration, I am checking n is equals to 3. So 3 square it is 9. Fine. So root 3 it is 1.732. Fine. So here we can observe here that n square value is great as compared to the n to the power 1 by 2. Fine. Or root n. Fine. So here n to the power log of a to the base b is greater than f of n value. So which case it is? It is case 1 again. It is case 1 again. Fine. So what I will put here? I will put here the equation for the case 1. What is the case 1 equation? T of n is equals to theta of n to the power log of a base b. Fine here. So T of n is equals to theta of, what is the n to the power log of a to the base b? It is n square. Fine. So this is the solution for this numerical. Again we are solving next numericals also. So here I am having the next numerical, that is T of n is equals to 4. T of n is equals to 4t, 4n by 3 plus n log n. Fine. So here what I will do here, I will just write down a is equals to 4, b is equals to, again I have to divide it by numerator and denominator by numerator value. What is the numerator value? 4. Fine. So 4n divided by 4 and 3 divided by 4 again. So I will get 3 divided b is equals to 3 divided by 4. So it is b is equals to 1.7. Fine. And f of n value is n log n. N log n. Fine. So can I directly compare n to the power log of a to the base b with f of n? No. I have to use here the consequent values of n. Fine. So here what I am doing, I am first of all calculating log of n to the power log of a to the base b is equals to n to the power log of a it is 4 and b it is 1.7. fine. So you can calculate, you can put these log values into the calculator and you will get n to the power 2.61. fine. I already told you how to use calculator to find out the log. Fine. So you are getting n to the power 2.61. fine. So here for the next, can I directly calculate? No, I can't calculate these two values directly. That's why I have to take the help of n consequent values. Fine. So I am dividing it into the three parts. So first part I have to put n is equals to values. In the second part I have to put n to the power 2.61, that is n to the power log of a to the base b, and next value I have to calculate for the n log n. Fine. So if n is equals to 1, if n is equals to 1, then 1 to the power 2.61, and then I have to use here 1 into log 1. Fine. So 1 to the power 2.61, it becomes 1, and 1 into log 1 becomes 0. Why it is 0? Because 1 into log 1, log 1 it is 0. That's why 1 into 0, that becomes 0. Fine. So next consequent value, that is n is equals to 2. Fine. So next consequent value, n is equals to 2. For that 2 to the power 2.61, I have to calculate, and here I have to calculate 2 into log 2. Fine. So 2 to the power 2.61, from calculator I will get 6.10, and 2 into log 2 I will get 0.602. Fine. So you can use calculator here to and put values directly and you will get 0.602. fine. For the second iteration again, it is n to the power log of a to the base b is greater as compared to f of n. Again n is equals to 3. I am again approximating my solution, make accuracy in the solution. So 3 to the power 2.61, so it is, I will get 17.59, and here 3 into log 3. 3 into log 3 I will get. You can directly put that values into the calculator. I am showing you here how 3 into log of 3 here. Fine. So for 1.431 you are getting 1.431. 4.431, fine. So here 1.431 and 3 to the power 2.61, fine. So here for the second, third iteration also, n value is greater as compared to n log n, fine. Again for the second, third iteration, fourth iteration also, I am checking n is equals to 4, that is 4 to the power 2.61 is equals to how much? In 4 into log of 4, fine. So 4 to the power 2.61, I will get 37.27, and 4 into log 4, I can calculate using this also. So 4 into log of 4, so I am getting 2.40, fine. Again, consequently, n value is greater as compared to the f of n value, fine. So for this, which I came into the conclusion that n to the power log of a to the base b is greater than f of n, fine. So which case it is? Again, case 1. So for the case 1, what is my solution? What is my equation? T of n is equals to theta of n to the power log of a to the base b, fine. So T of n is equals to theta of n to the power 2.61, fine. So this is my solution for this numerical. Again, for the next numerical, T of n is equals to 4n by 3 plus n square. Again, I am calculating what is the value of a. Value of a it is 4. What is the value of b? B it is 3 by 4. I already explained you that is numerator value it is 4. So we have to divide the numerator and denominator by 4. That is 4n divided by 4 and 3 divided by 4. So 4n divided by 4 again becomes 1n, and 3 divided by 4 is my b value, fine. And then f of n is equals to n square, fine. So n to the power log of a, that is 4, and 3 by 4, it is 1.7. so I am getting n to the power 2.61 here, fine. So what is the value of f of n? F of n it is n square. So already here 2.61 is greater than n square, fine. So can I directly compare these values? Yes, I can, because n power is slight greater than f of n power, fine. So I came into conclusion that f of n, that is n to the power log of a to the base b, log of a to the base b is greater than f of n. You can directly write it down because I can compare here directly, fine. If it is log value or any other value, then I have to take the next consequent values of s, fine. So what I am getting here, this value is greater, that's why this is case 1. So what is the equation for case 1? Case 1 it is T of n is equals to theta of n to the power log of a to the base b, fine. So T of n is equals to theta of n to the power log a to the base b, that is 2.61, fine. So this is my solution for this numerical. So after solving many more examples on the Master's theorem, these are the three numericals. You have to solve it by your own. These are the homework for you, and it is university repeated questions, and make more practice of it. And for the next video, we'll go for the asymptotic notation and various types of asymptotic notations and examples of asymptotic notation, how to solve it, we will see in the next lecture. Fine. Thank you.